I think this will be the first thing you see in the Inge video. Something on fire.
No. You definitely need to have some knitting and stuff.
Yeah.
To balance me up.
I've been knit bombing for like 4 years, maybe 5. I didn't know there was a thing called knit bombing, or there was something that many people did. It was just a crazy idea I had.
Definitely too short. Maybe I can.
No. Okay. No or on?
I like on.
I like on too, actually. No.
Cause no.
That's fun too. No, you can't push the button. No.
But on is like,
yeah,
if you push the
on,
button, then you turn
it
on.
Yeah, but if I push the button, it's still on. Because it's on.
No, caipirinha.
Yeah.
Strawberry caipirinha.
On the Thai boat in Stockholm. And I'm with my friend Inga. I'm going to film her in a minute.
Hi.
Cheers.
Cheers. School.
Sorry. Looks like a phone, so it's easy to get away with filming people without them knowing. Hi, Alba.
She's hard to catch.
Hi. Took it in his hand.
What are my neighbors gonna do? Nu, oj! Nu brinner det, titta! Doesn't smell that good.
Orka lite på mig!
Åh, vad
äckligt!
Så kan man också släcka. Så det blir så här.
Marshmallow.
I'm not gonna be an on fire zombie, but
I think it looks pretty zombified right now.
Yeah, it's supposed to be holes somewhere. Det blir bra. Kolla, så har jag den på mig. Så, okay. I think we're done.
Mm-hmm. Need these to stick onto the skin, no matter what. Maggot balls, maggot eggs. Then we just take some zombie flesh stuff.
Hey, I'm getting grossed out by my own skin.
Vet du vad? Kan koppla bort högtalaren och den sladden och gå när.
Even I'm getting grossed out. I know it's fake, but so jättekul. Inga has bloody slippers for her
slippers.
Yeah. It started with me collecting mittens, actually. Lost mittens. When I had like hundreds of them, I started thinking, what am I gonna do with them? I just took the yarn and made something new of them and started thinking that I found them in the streets, so whatever I needed from this belongs in the street. By chance, I came across a woman who was also a knit bomber. And we started talking about art, and I told her about my mitten project. And she was like, oh, you're a knit bomber. And I was like, there's a word for it? There are others? I think I'm gonna do more of these boxes with buttons. If you want to know why I do it, or why I keep doing it, it's because it's part of a bigger issue. I knit bomb because it's fun and I do fun stuff, but it has a deeper level to it. It's about the traditional female handicraft. Women over decades haven't been given any credit or pay at all for the work they do, and it's hard. Knitting, crocheting, it's hard. Hard for your body, hard for your neck, for your shoulders. And earlier days, like 100 years ago, it was also hard for your vision. This is actually yarn abuse. I've been doing art since I was a small kid, so I've always had art in different forms besides regular school. I think we need knit bombing as an art to lift the handcraft, to show that this is equal to cool graffiti.
It's all
people think it's like wow because it's dying out. But you can still buy a knitted sweater at H&M for nothing. The value of the work that's been laid onto it is this big. The price is this small. I want to show the world knitting and crocheting.